Hello and welcome to pdfsupply.com. Today we're going to be testing an RX3i bus controller. This is an IC694BEM331. It's attached to an IC695CHS007 7 slot rack. It's being powered by an IC695PSA040 power supply. And the controller I'm using for this test is an IC695CPU320. Okay, so a few things about this test before we get started. I'm connecting to the processor, with an HE693CBL232 cable. This is 9-pin serial on both ends, and in order to connect to a 15-pin COM port 2, I'm using an adapter called an HE693SNP232. Okay. As you can see that I've had the power supply powered up and my CPU OK light is on, and my OK light is on my bus controller. So everything has gone through its self-diagnostic and it lands in the OK mode. If for some reason you're testing your BEM331 and you don't have an OK light, or if it's red, that means that there's something wrong with the bus controller and you won't be able to follow this test. There's something critically wrong with it and it would need replacement or repair. Okay. In addition to those items for this test, I'm going to need some sort of, and I'm going to show you guys, the terminal strip I've removed. And the terminal strip communicates through serial 1 and serial 2. Serial 1 is any of the terminal screws 1 through 5, and serial 2 is 6 through 10. Okay, so what I've made here is I call it a bus controller rig. This is a test fixture that I've made. Serial 1 is the yellow, serial 2 is the black. And on the other end of this, if you guys haven't seen one of these yet, this is a part made by Phoenix Contact. Its type is UMK-SE1125-1. All right, and what this does is it converts the serial 1 and serial 2 in a way that I can use it with this male 9-pin connector. All right, now the male 9-pin connector is going to be attached to my IC660HHM handheld monitor 501. Okay, this is the part of the Genius group. You guys, if you have a bus controller and Genius blocks, I'm sure you're familiar with that. But if not, that's the part number, IC660HHM501. Now I'm going to attach the terminal strip, and I'm going to plug my Genius controller, my handheld monitor, into the 9-pin port. Okay. Okay. Next thing is, in the software, I'm using Proficy Machine Edition. All right. Now what I've done is I've chosen a new blank file, and I'm going to expand if you guys are following my arrow here. Now I'm going to expand on rack 0, hit the plus sign. I'm in my navigator. And I'm going to just go back over the actual physical configuration I have in front of you. This is the IC695CHS007 7 slot rack. Slots 0 and 1 is being used by the IC695PSA040 power supply. And slots 2 and 3 are being used by our processor, IC695CPU320. So bear that in mind, that the first 4 slots, 0 through 3, are being used by your power supply and the processor. Slot number 4 is empty, and what we're going to do is right click on that, where you can double click and select add module. And we're going to go to bus controller, and this is the IC694BEM331. Alright. Now, what I'm going to do is, you can see that there's some editable values here. If we've got the tab open for slot 4, it's configured with the BEM331. The settings and the parameters are as listed below. The serial bus address is 31. The data rate, or bits per second, is 153.6 standard. And then there's some reference addresses and other values that are editable. And then, of course, there's global data, which when that screen pops up, it shows where you're able to configure your devices. But we'll stick with settings for right now. All right, and the next thing you're going to do is connect up to the processor using the lightning bolt icon. All right, and then always look down below at what your status is. The status where, if you're following my arrow here, monitor stop disabled. Stop disabled relates to the input and output, and configuration not equal, logic not equal. I'm going to hit the handprint and toggle into online mode. Now, my configuration and logic are still not equal. My outputs are disabled still, but I'm in programmer mode. So that we're able to download this physical information. Before we do that, though, we're going to go to Target, Online Commands, Clear, and we're going to clear the bottom two, Controller Fault Table and I/O Fault Table, and select OK. Yes, we want to do that. That just, if there's any faults in the processor from whatever it was doing before, that's just going to keep us from getting hung up when we try to download this, all right? Download and start active target. This is the icon that shows information being downloaded in the run button in one. The first thing it's going to ask us is what do we want to download exactly? And this is hardware configuration and motion and logic. This is just a test on the BEM331. It's a simple test. We just want to see if it's out there, if it's communicating. And we don't want to write anything to permanent flash memory. Okay. I'm going to tell you guys a little bit about the IC660HHM501, this handheld monitor. For this particular test, what I want to do is I want to be able to see the communication of the BEM331 through this monitor, and that tells me that it's out there. It's a working device, and it's out there, and I can find it. All right. And once our build is finished or our download is finished, I'm going to select that we can turn on the outputs. We're going to hit OK to that. And now, if you look down below, one more time, programmer mode, run enabled, configuration and logic are both equal. So your status bar should read as mine does, run enabled, configuration and logic both equal, all right? And if for some reason you're not in run mode, always check your switches, because this switch disables the outputs, disables the run mode. It should be in the far right position for this test. Okay, that'll also hang you up if you don't have that correct. Another thing you want to note is that the BEM331 now, the comm light is on, the communication light is on. That's another thing that you have to see once we reach run mode, okay? If it didn't read that, then there'd be something wrong with it. So, now on the handheld monitor, I'm going to go ahead and turn this on right now. Let's see if I can position this so you guys can see it. Maybe that's best. I'm going to select OK. And that's, I'm OKing the baud rate, which is the same matching baud rate as the BEM is set up for, 153.6 standard. Okay. There are four settings and there are four choices in Proficy Machine Edition. Next thing I'm going to do is hit F2 for analyze, and F3 for block bus status. And as I mentioned to you guys before, the bus address is 31, and this V1.7 refers to the EEPROM, the version or the revision of the EEPROM that's on the actual card itself. It's 1.7, and that is correct. So the bus address matches what we have in Proficy Machine Edition, pardon me, and the 1.7 version is correct for this particular bus controller. All right. Now, if you guys have failed to find, or if your OK light isn't on, if your communication light doesn't come on, or if you guys fail to get as far as I did with this handheld monitor. So it seems that everything is fine here, but when you attach it to the handheld monitor, you're unable to see any communication through the monitor. Then there's definitely something wrong with the bus controller, okay? And it, again, would need replacement or repair. These BEM331s is something that we very commonly repair here at PDF Supply. We offer exchange programs, new and remanufactured products, and same-day shipping. So if that's something that you need or interests you, please see us at pdfsupply.com. Thank you.